Hey everyone, it's Nick again, and today let's talk about vitamin B12 and diabetes. There are some very specific things about them many people don't know about. So let's reveal that today while talking about why you may have vitamin B12 deficiency when you have diabetes. What are the main symptoms of such deficiency, and what can you do about it? Let's get into it. All right, why am I paying such close attention to this specific B12 vitamin? First of all, it's because it's a central nutrient that helps your body create DNA and make healthy red blood cells, as well as nourishes the brain and nervous system. Secondly, B12 is a vitamin that people with diabetes are often deficient in. A 2009 study found that 22% of people with type 2 diabetes were low in vitamin B12, and that's highly prevalent among people with type 1 diabetes as well. But why does that happen? Well, it's most likely due to the use of blood sugar lowering medication, such as metformin. The risk of low vitamin B12 levels increases with its higher dose, longer treatment duration, and if the person with diabetes has risk factors for vitamin B12 deficiency. So, how to understand if you're deficient in vitamin B12, and what are the main symptoms? Now, take a closer look at this list. Here you can see the main symptoms that say you have vitamin B12 deficiency. If you experience such symptoms in your everyday life, this will help you avoid more serious complications that appear when your B12 levels are very low. Such complications include the loss of taste and smell, irregular heartbeat, and shortness of breath or anemia, meaning you lack enough healthy red blood cells to carry oxygen to your body tissues. Now, before moving forward to even more important points about diabetes and vitamin B12, hit that subscribe button on the Klinio channel. We are here to give you all the needed information about diabetes and its management. And I promise, we make difficult things easy to understand. Let's move forward. So how is vitamin B12 deficiency diagnosed? If you have symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency, see your doctor right away. Just a simple blood test can determine if you are low in B12. When you have diabetes, your doctor will probably need to evaluate you more carefully, including physical examination and checking your blood glucose levels. However, there are some things you can do to maintain stable vitamin B12 levels without reaching deficiency. The thing is, your body doesn't make this vitamin itself, so you have to get it from animal-based foods or supplements. So you should include more meat, fish, poultry, eggs, and dairy products into your diet. There are also some foods that may be fortified with vitamin B12, including cereal, bread, or tofu. The recommended daily intake of vitamin B12 for adults is 2.4 micrograms. Now, your doctor may also advise you take oral vitamin B12 supplements or give you injections if you're severely deficient. Okay, everyone, we're not done here yet. So watch the next video about the essential vitamins and minerals for diabetes and another one about the top 5 hacks on how to make eating with diabetes easier.